Whitewater-Baldy Fire was started by lightning and burned about 300,000 acres of the Gila National Forest, making it the largest fire in New Mexico's history. Now that the fire is largely contained, attention is shifted to preparing for post-fire flooding with the onset of the monsoon season. USGS scientists installed rain gages at Mogollon-Baldy Lookout and Hummingbird Saddle in the Gila Wilderness area.
This is the trail up to Hummingbird Saddle, and it's nice to see already. Got some new growth here. There's new life popping up. I've never seen anything so charred. All the way to the top. But you can hear the birds singing. This is our work site. We're starting to prepare equipment for the rain gauge. Still some fires burning off in the distance. So we've got the rain gauge mostly erected. The big parts are put together. Robert and Brian are finishing mixing the concrete. Got the hole dug, and we're about ready to drop that thing in and add another bag of concrete.
So we got a rain gauge up there, goes antenna, solar panel, all the usual stuff. It's on a tower here. Here's the base we poured. We're installing the stream flow gauge here at Mineral Creek. Got Kurt up there hooking up the rain gauge. And Fletcher's getting ready to scale the wall here, do a little recon run to see where we're going to run our orifice line.
Collected data will allow scientists and emergency managers to evaluate the increased risk of flooding resulting from burned areas within watersheds. Gauge data can also be used to determine the rate of a watershed's recovery. The gauges provide warnings to communities that may be affected by flooding and can provide up to 60 minutes advance warning of impending floods.
Fletcher and Ken are finishing up the orifice line.
There's Jeff Balmont. Jeff and Hannah are finishing up with the DCP. You got the orifice right there, attached to the T-Rex mount system.
Stream gauges installed in burned areas need a variety of sensors to handle the extreme conditions of runoff. Non-contact sensors, such as radar, can be used alongside redundant sensors to ensure the survivability of the gauge. The installation of early warning gauges was a cooperative effort by the New Mexico Department of Security and Emergency Management, the Natural Resource Conservation Service, the U.S. Forest Service, and the USGS. The gauges ensure that emergency managers have the critical information they need to help the residents located downstream of the fire protect themselves and their homes from potential flooding.